This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com on another field trip, and we're in the middle of Boston today, and we're in front of a church. Actually, the church is across the street there. We're going to go over and see that they're even growing food in their front yard or their church ground. So let's go check out food growing here at this huge church in Boston. All right, so we're at Old South Church in Boston, and they have the gardens. And the section of the garden near Dartmouth Street is an organic vegetable garden. They have some corns, beans, tomatoes, and greens growing. So let's go check it out. We're in front of this old church, so you could grow food anywhere. So here it is, the Garden of Eden, an edible churchyard. So this garden is growing organic vegetables to help feed the guests of the Women's Lunch Place, a daytime refuge for homeless women and their children. So you too could feed homeless women and children in raised beds. So it looks like they have raised beds, and this is actually the end of the season here. We're here in middle of October. So we're standing here in the church. And you know, this is just a small area here in the front of the church. Busy passerbyers here. Nice rainy Boston day. And you know, they just have six beds, and they're about 4 feet wide and about 8 feet long. And they're just basically using really easy construction. All it is a 4x4 post there. And basically these are fence boards, looks like. 8 feet long fence boards to the edges. Like I said, the end of the season here, they had some corn growing. And they still got tomatoes here on the plants. Some small tomato cages. There's a ripe tomato there. And a bean trellis with some bamboo trellises. And you know what? You could grow a lot of food in just, you know, six raised beds. These are 4x8 raised beds. I'm sure they did the square foot gardening method. And you could grow a lot of food. And even if it's just for your family, start off with one raised bed. I mean, if they could do it in a church yard here in Boston, you know, busy Boston, buses driving by, you could grow food in your front yard or your backyard. Oh, I see nasturtiums growing. Here's some dino kale. Looks like the dino kale is still doing quite well. Right there. Got a nice bright light on the church and in the camera. And bean trellises look like they're still doing really well. So here's more of the church garden. This is the inedible part, so it's not the edible part, but definitely looks beautiful here in the front. And I suppose the other side of the church where they have the edible garden now was probably like this. And look really nice. So you too can grow food anywhere. So it's really popular these days for churches to start growing food on their land. Many churches have large lots and they don't use it all for prayer or meetings or whatever they need it for. So, you know, churches have, especially in my area, have been turning it into community gardens to offer plots to the community so that they could use the land. Also to grow food for the homeless and for the congregation. So another thing to do is to ask your church if they have extra space where you could start a community garden or, you know, grow food for the needy. So once again, this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time.